always seem to go, that you don't know what you've got till it's gone. They paid paradise, put up a parking lot.
Earth Day demonstrations began in practically every city and town in the United States this morning, the first massive nationwide protest against the pollution of the environment. In Washington, there was an awesome Earth Day warning from a government scientist. Dr. J. Murray Mitchell said pollution and overpollution, unless checked, could so warm the Earth in 200 years as to create a greenhouse effect, melting the Arctic ice cap and flooding vast areas of the world.
Nationally, Earth Day was the largest demonstration ever in American history. Some events had 500,000 people in them, and we had an estimated 20 million across the country.
Some quarters saw more than coincidence in the fact that Earth Day occurred on the 100th anniversary of the birth of Lenin, the father of Soviet communism. The Comptroller General of Georgia, James Bentley, sent out $1,600 worth of telegrams warning that Earth Day might be a communist plot.
There were certainly people who had their pet causes. Some pounded vehicles apart with sledgehammers as a protest against the internal combustion engine. Others wore gas masks to protest air pollution. But also there was an almost celebratory thing, as though suddenly we were awakening to a new set of opportunities.
They are talking about emission control devices on automobiles, while we are talking about bans on automobiles. We are challenging the ethics of a society that, with only 6% of the world's population, accounts for more than half of its utilization of resources. Our country is stealing from the poorer countries of the world.
It's amazing to me that this week marks the 50th anniversary of the first Earth Day celebration. While I'm old enough to remember that occasion, my memories of April 22, 1970 are blurry at best. While I don't have very distinct memories of what happened on the first Earth Day, I do have very powerful memories as to why I think it happened. Those memories are brought into sharp focus by one of the most indelible photographs I've ever seen, shown here. This image, broadcast from space on July 16, 1969, the summer of my senior year, was taken aboard Apollo 11 by astronaut Neil Armstrong while en route to the moon, just 4 days before his historic one small step, one giant leap walk on its surface. If you look closely, you can even see the vague outline of the west coast of North America peeking out among the clouds. It occurred to me then, strange but true, that my family, friends, and everybody we knew who called the Bay Area home were included in that photo. Images like this of the Earth seen from space, a beautiful, dazzling, colorful, lonely planet floating in all that darkness, are simply unforgettable. More than anything, they mark the dawning of the realization that our precious, rare, lovely, living world, our spaceship Earth, is our home and the only home we will ever have. I think that realization is why, 50 years ago this week, tens of millions of people around the world came together to celebrate the very first Earth Day.
Happy Earth Day, everyone. Your Mama Pretz here. In 1970, I was a high school junior in Providence, Rhode Island. On the first Earth Day, I volunteered to help clean up the Providence River. Now, I'd never been to the river's edge. Like many rivers in the days before the Clean Water Act, it was a cesspool for industries that lined its banks. It was a place of crime and decay, filth and death. The water was thick, black, smelled terrible. There were 40 of us. We put on rubber overalls and gloves and waded in. We hauled out old tires and paint cans and rusted junk and nasty things I'm not going to even tell you about. When we were done, the There was a big pile of awful, awful trash. And the river looked and smelled kind of like it did before we started. On that Earth Day, though, thousands of such projects were begun, and probably there were many people who felt as disappointed in the results as I did. But it turns out it all added up to something very big. In Providence, every Earth Day after that, more and more people came, and the river, 10 years later, it was transformed. Fish are now swimming in that water, and the river banks are beautiful parklands, much beloved. The first Earth Day led to the bipartisan passage of 28 environmental laws, including the Clean Water Act, the Clean Air Act, the Endangered Species Act, and the Environmental Protection Agency. They were all signed by a Republican president, Richard Nixon. Now, Earth Day is celebrated in almost every country and is the largest secular holiday on Earth. Today, as we see all those gains under attack, we may feel that our situation is dire. Let's remember, history shows that no matter how hopeless it may appear, young people acting together can change the world. Now, you can get started by checking out the EcoLeader Earth Day activities and log in to EarthRise. Make your Earth Day powerful.
We stand to lose everything if we don't tackle the climate crisis head on.
If we don't begin to change immediately, not in 5 years or 10 years, but in 2020, then the planet will be permanently impoverished.
It's not just about young people skipping school. It's about people dying right now in Miami, in Lower Ninth Ward in Louisiana, and in Petaluma, California. That when we start taking those voices seriously, that's when we'll start seeing action. That's when we'll start seeing real changes.
This is one battle that we cannot afford to lose.
Hello, friends. I'm Cristiana Figueres.
I'm Dennis Hayes.
My name is Kathy Shepard.
My name is Jamie Margolin.
Hi, my name is Angela. I am from Chile, and I am a climate activist with Fridays for Future Santiago.
My name is Rev Lennox Yearwood Jr., President and CEO of the Hip Hop Caucus.
I was the national organizer of the first Earth Day back in 1970.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lisa Priyakumbhajan. I'm 8 years old.
The year of 2020 is the year of truth. This is the year that we must make sure that our voices are heard.
It's been 50 years since the first Earth Day, and we have grown as a movement, and we are stronger than ever.
It is also the beginning of the most consequential decade that humanity has ever faced.
We need justice for the environment, for humanity, and for future generations.
Black, white, brown, red, male, female, straight, gay, theist, atheist, human. We're all in this together.
And we can do it because we, the human species, have never had the capital, the policies, and the technologies to put together in order to transform our world. We can create the future that we want.
The people need to turn out all over the world in any election that is happening and vote. If you have a democracy, you need to participate and you need to vote.
We get hundreds of thousands of young people to register to vote to make sure that politicians see the issue of climate change as the top priority in 2020.
I will be out in the streets and I hope you will be too.
We're unstoppable and another world is possible and the change is possible.
On Earth Day 2020, let's fight for our future.
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 Ya es tiempo para pelear para nuestro futuro.
Let's fight for our future.
Mm-hmm.